Hello, I am Pastor Jennifer. Let us continue with our Overcommit series. Today's topic is 일이일비. The word 일이일비, which is composed of four Chinese characters, means feeling happy on the one hand and sad on the other. It may also mean being now glad, now sad, that is, being so fickle and changeable in heart or moods, being agitated so easily by the given circumstances. It is like the ups and downs in moods that Israelites exhibited after they came out of Egypt, giving joyful thanks to God the Savior. Let me introduce Caleb, a man of steadfast heart, the total opposite of a man of a fickle and changeable heart. His steadfast heart shone like a gem when Moses sent 12 spies out to the land of Canaan at God's command. They represented their own tribes, and Caleb participated as the leader of the tribe of Judah. The 12 spies spent the same 40 days in Canaan, observing the land, fruits, cities, and the inhabitants there carefully. However, their reports were different. 10 out of the 12 said, "It certainly does flow with milk and honey. Nevertheless, the people who live in the land are strong, and the cities are fortified and very large. And moreover, we saw the descendants of Anak there." Only two people, Joshua and Caleb, said, "We should by all means go up and take possession of it, or we will surely overcome it." Then the 10 men who thought negatively opposed their idea intensely, saying, "The inhabitants there are much bigger and mightier than us, and the land swallows the inhabitants." They even say, "We are like grasshoppers in our own sight, and so we are in their sight." Their faith in God's promise to give them the land is completely gone. The congregation heard their negative words and were agitated like the boiling water in the pot. They wept loudly all night and grumbled against Moses and Aaron, their top leaders. They even say, "It would be better for us to return to Egypt." Feeling their hostility, Moses and Aaron fall on their faces before the entire congregation of the sons of Israel. At that time, Caleb and Joshua tear their clothes and speak to the congregation, "The land which we pass through to spy out is an exceedingly good land. If the Lord is pleased with us, then He will bring us into this land and give it to us, a land which flows with milk and honey. Only do not rebel against the Lord, and do not fear the people of the land, for they will be our prey. Their protection has been removed from them, and the Lord is with us. Do not fear them." What a steadfast mind and faith. However, hearing their words, all the congregation say to stone them with stones. And right at the time, the glory of the Lord appeared in the tent of meeting to all the sons of Israel. These two men with such a steadfast heart were the very ones God was very pleased with. God had all spies who made the entire congregation grumble die by a plague, along with those who were agitated by their words and grumbled, while letting only the two, Joshua and Caleb, survive. Caleb's heart did not change at all by the time he turned 85, 45 years later. Out of the same steadfastness, he said to Joshua, who was in charge of distributing the land of Canaan to Israeli tribes like this. I am still as strong today as I was in the day Moses sent me. As my strength was then, so my strength is now, or and for going out and coming in. Now then, give me this hill country about which the Lord spoke on that day, or you heard on that day that Anakim were there with great fortified cities. Perhaps the Lord will be with me, and I will drive them out as the Lord has spoken. The Bible shows us in verses 13 to 14 what happened after that. Joshua 14, 13 to 14. So Joshua blessed him and gave Hebron to Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, for an inheritance. Therefore, Hebron became the inheritance of Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, the Kenizzite, until this day, because he followed the Lord, God of Israel, fully. So far, it's been a story of Caleb that makes us think about whom to follow and how to follow with what's of mine. From now, let me recommend some 5 quotes on steadfastness in 5 categories. First, God is the sovereign Lord over all firm establishments of people or nations. Psalm 93:1-2. The Lord reigns. He is clothed with majesty. The Lord has clothed and girded himself with strength. Indeed, the world is firmly established. It will not be moved. Your throne is established from of old. You are from everlasting. Psalm 33:9. For he spoke, and it was done. He commanded, and it stood fast. David's song of deliverance. 2 Samuel 22:32-33. For who is God besides the Lord? And who is a rock besides our God? God is my strong fortress, and he sets the blameless in his way. The Psalm of David. Psalm chapter 40, verse 2. He brought me up out of the pit of destruction, out of the miry clay, and he set my feet upon the rock, making my footsteps firm. What God spoke to David before he died. 2 Samuel 7:12-13. When your days are complete, and you lie down with your fathers, I will raise up your descendant after you, who will come forth from me, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. Second, spiritual establishments or confirmation. 1 Corinthians 1:4-8. I thank my God always concerning you for the grace of God which was given you in Christ Jesus, that in everything you are enriched in him, in all speech and all knowledge, even as the testimony concerning Christ was confirmed in you, so that you are not lacking in any gift, awaiting eagerly the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ, who will also confirm you to the end, blameless in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Third, blessings upon those who are steadfast in mind and faith. Isaiah 26:3. The steadfast of mind you will keep in perfect peace, because he trusts in you. Psalm 112:6-8. For he will never be shaken. The righteous will be remembered forever. He will not fear evil tidings. His heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. His heart is upheld. He will not fear until he looks with satisfaction on his adversaries. Proverbs 14:26. In the fear of the Lord there is strong confidence, and his children will have refuge. God himself fights for those who trust him fully. 2 Chronicles 20:22-23. They rose early in the morning and went down to the wilderness of Tekoa. And when they went out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, Listen to me, O Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem. Put your trust in the Lord your God, and you will be established. Put your trust in his prophets and succeed. When he had consulted with the people, he appointed those who sang to the Lord and those who praised him in holy attire as they went out before the army and said, Give thanks to the Lord, for his loving kindness is everlasting. When they began singing and praising, the Lord set ambushes against the sons of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, who had come against Judah. So they were routed. For the sons of Ammon and Moab rose up against the inhabitants of Mount Seir, destroying them completely. And when they had finished with the inhabitants of Seir, they helped to destroy one another. Romans 4:18-22. In hope, against hope he believed, so that he might become a father of many nations according to that which had been spoken. So shall your descendants be. Without becoming weak in faith, he contemplated his own body, now as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old, and the deadness of Sarah's womb. Yet, with respect to the promise of God, he did not waver in unbelief, but grew strong in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully assured that what God had promised, he was able also to perform. Therefore, it was also credited to him as righteousness. Fourth, a heart for believing saints to have. Hebrews 11:6. And without faith it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who seek him. Philippians 3:10-14. That I may know him, and the power of his resurrection, and the fellowship of his sufferings, being conformed to his death, in order that I may attain to the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already obtained it, or have already become perfect, but I press on so that I may lay hold of that for which also I was laid hold of by Christ Jesus. Brethren, I do not regard myself as having laid hold of it yet. But one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Hebrews 3:14. For we have become partakers of Christ if we hold fast the beginning of our assurance firm until the end. 1 Peter 5:9-10. But resist them, firm in your faith, knowing that the same experiences of suffering are being accomplished by your brethren who are in the world. After you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself perfect, confirm, strengthen, and establish you. 1 John 5:4-5. For whatever is born of God overcomes the world, and this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith. Who is the one who overcomes the world? Body who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. Matthew 21:21-22. And Jesus answered and said to them, Truly I say to you, if you have faith and do not doubt, you will not only do what was done to the fig tree, but even if you say to this mountain, Be taken up and cast into the sea, it will happen. And all things you ask in prayer, believing, you will receive. Fifth, prayer for God's help. Psalm chapter 31, verse 2. Incline your ear to me, rescue me quickly. Be to me a rock of strength, a stronghold to save me. Psalm 68:28. Your God has commanded your strength. Show yourself strong, O God, who have acted on our behalf. Prayer by Moses, the man of God. Psalm 90:17. Let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us, and confirm for us the work of our hands. Yes, confirm the work of our hands. Luke 17:5. Increase our faith. Amen. This is all for today, and I pray that today's word will help us stand firm in faith and not be shaken by anything that distracts us from God. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.